In this particular lecture, we will go through the complex numbers. We will go through complex numbers. Okay. So this lecture will be an introduction on complex numbers. This lecture will be an introduction of complex numbers. So before starting with complex numbers, we need to discuss what is a real number. What is a real number? So the basic definition of real numbers is that a number x such that a number x such that x square is greater than or equal to 0 is said to be real. Okay, a number x such that x square is greater than equal to 0 is said to be real. Okay, now real numbers can be classified into two parts. One is algebraic and one is transcendental. What are algebraic complex numbers? The numbers which can be retrieved as the root of some algebraic polynomial equation or some algebraic equation is said to be an algebraic real number, and the numbers which cannot be retrieved as a root of a particular algebraic equation are called transcendental numbers. So transcendental numbers, the examples of transcendental numbers are pi and e. Pi and e are transcendental numbers. Algebraic numbers can be further divided into rationals and irrationals. Rationals and irrationals. Now, what are irrationals? Irrationals are those particular numbers which cannot be expressed. Irrationals are those particular numbers, let them be say s, which cannot be expressed in the form of p over q, where gcd of p and q equal to 1. Okay, where the gcd of p and q is equal to 1. Okay, they cannot be expressed in a fraction form. While rationals are those numbers which can be expressed in the form of a fraction p over q, where the gcd of p and q is 1. Okay, now these rationals can be further divided into naturals and integers. Okay, these rationals can be further divided into naturals and integers, and we can say fractions. Basically, we do not involve the naturals here. Let this be divided into integers and fractions. So what are integers? Integers are the rationals r equals to p over q, where q can divide p. Okay, this is a symbol of divisibility, where q can divide p. Okay, acha. And what are the fractions? Fractions is that where q cannot divide p. Got it? Okay, I have wrongly written it as b. Very sorry. So fractions. So here q cannot divide p. Okay. I'm having some problem with my S pen basically. That's why I'm getting into these misprints. Okay, one second. Okay, so q cannot divide p. Okay. Okay. So now let's see an exceptional point. Now, what is that exceptional point? Now suppose we take an equation. Suppose we take an equation. Let the equation be x square plus 1 equals to 0. Okay. From here we can say that x equals to root over of minus 1. But we know one thing, that if x equals to root over of minus 1, then x can't be a real number. As by the definition of real number, a number x such that x square is always greater than or equal to 0 can be real. So x cannot be real. That means ki x, now if x is not real, if x is not real, that means we can say that the root does not exist. We can say this, the root does not exist. But basically, over thousands of era where mathematics has slowly developed, we have found that x equals to root over of minus 1, this value is of very high importance in certain cases. So basically mathematicians thought of introducing a new sort of number which is known as a complex number. So basically complex number was introduced to mathematics to study the numbers whose square would be minus 1. Okay, so from there we got a new kind of number known as the imaginary number. Okay, and that imaginary number is given as I, which is known as iota, and I square is minus 1. That is, if x equals to root over of minus 1, then x equals to I. Okay, so this is the basic introduction to complex numbers. Now, properties of complex numbers. Now, the basic structure of a complex number is given as z equals to a plus ib, where a and b both belong to the set of real numbers, and this is the form of a complex number. Okay, next part we have REZ means the real portion of Z. It is given as A. And IMZ, that is the imaginary portion of Z. In the above case, it was the real portion of Z. In the second case, it is the imaginary portion of Z. It is known as, it will be B. Okay. So, the real number which is multiplied with I is said to be the imaginary portion of the complex number. In the third portion, we have, this is known as the modulus of Z or the mod of Z. This equals to R, I mean this is also signified as R, and this is equals to A square plus B square. The fourth case we have argument of Z, also signified as theta, is given as tan inverse of B over A, and this is a very important thing to note, that theta always belongs to the closed interval minus pi to pi. Okay, theta always belongs to the closed interval minus pi to pi. Okay, now let us discuss the graphical representation of these properties. Okay, so the plane on which a complex number is plotted, is known as an Argand plane. Okay, we usually plot Cartesian coordinates on a Cartesian plane, and complex numbers are plotted on an Argand plane. Now we know that real numbers can be easily plotted on a number line, but complex numbers cannot be, because to define a complex number we need two real numbers. So the two real numbers needs to be plotted on two different number lines, and the two different number lines are arranged in an Argand plane, where the horizontal number line is known as the real axis एंड द वर्टिकल नंबर लाइन इज नोन एज द इमेजिनरी एक्सिस सिमिलरली टू द एक्स एंड वाई एक्सिस ऑफ द कार्टेशियन प्लेन. नाउ द पॉइंट दैट इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड विच इज गिवेन एज ए प्लस आई बी रिप्रेजेंट्स द कोऑर्डिनेट ए बी ओके वेर दिस डिस्टेंस इज ए एंड दिस डिस्टेंस इज बी. गॉट दिस. नाउ इफ आई जॉइन द ऑरिजिन विद दैट पर्टिकुलर कोऑर्डिनेट देन द लेंथ ऑफ द लाइन जॉइनिंग द ऑरिजिन विद दैट पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट इज गिवन एज आर एंड द एंगल बिटवीन आर द क्लॉकवाइज द एंटी क्लॉकवाइज एंगल बिटवीन आर एंड द रियल एक्सिस इज गिवन एज थीटा. ओके सो दिस आर इज बेसिकली मॉड ऑफ जेड दैट इज इक्वल टू रूट ओवर ऑफ ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर एंड दिस थीटा इज नथिंग बट टेन इनवर्स ऑफ बी ओवर. सो दिस इज अ ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स. नाउ देयर इज वन मोर पॉइंट इन अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर विच इज नोन एज द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए वेट अ मिनट विच इज नोन एज कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए आई एम हैविंग सम प्रॉब्लम विद द एस पेन वेट अ मिनट गाइज. ओके विच इज कॉल्ड द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. वॉट इज द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर फॉर अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड इक्वल्स टू ए प्लस आई बी जेड बार इक्वल्स टू ए प्लस आई टाइम्स माइनस आई बी और ए माइनस आई बी इज द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ जेड. ओके ऑलवेज रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट बी कैन बी पॉजिटिव एंड बी कैन बी नेगेटिव. इफ बी इज पॉजिटिव एंड ए इज ऑल्सो पॉजिटिव देन ए प्लस आई बी इज द वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज ए प्लस आई बी. बट इफ बी इज नेगेटिव देन वी कैन राइट द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इन टू फॉर्म्स वन इज ए माइनस आई बी एंड वन इज ए प्लस आई ऑफ माइनस बी. दिस इज द मोस्ट फेवरेबल फॉर्म एज राइटिंग अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इन द फॉर्म ए प्लस एक्स प्लस आई वाई इज एक्चुअली द कन्वेंशन. ओके नाउ हाउ कैन वी प्लॉट द कॉन्जुगेट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर ऑन द आर्गन प्लेन. सो बेसिकली इफ आई रिफ्लेक्ट द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड अलॉन्ग द रियल एक्सिस आई मीन अबाउट द रियल एक्सिस देन आई विल गेट द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर द कॉन्जुगेट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर देन आई विल ऑटोमेटिकली गेट द कॉन्जुगेट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर दैट इज ए माइनस बी. गॉट इट. नाउ वी विल मूविंग ऑन टू द पोलर फॉर्म ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. नाउ वी विल बी मूविंग ऑन टू द पोलर फॉर्म ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. ओके सो व्हाट इज पोलर फॉर्म ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. फॉर अ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस आई वाई वी कैन रिप्रेजेंट दिस कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर एज आर टाइम्स कॉस थीटा प्लस आई साइन थीटा. दिस फॉर्म दिस वे ऑफ राइटिंग द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर जेड इक्वल्स टू एक्स प्लस आई वाई इज नोन एज द पोलर फॉर्म ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. नाउ हाउ कैन वी राइट एक्स प्लस आई वाई एज आर कॉस थीटा प्लस आई साइन थीटा. सो इट इज प्रीटी इजी टू सी. See from this diagram, see I have taken here x plus iy, so we can basically compare x with a. So basically see that a is equals to r cos theta here and b is equals to r sin theta here. Similarly x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sine theta. Putting them in these places, we get that r cos theta plus I r sine theta. So taking r common, we get this particular thing. And this form can be further written as r times e to the power I theta. Okay, so we can write this is as r times e to the power I theta. Getting my point, guys? So we keep this lecture up till this much. In the next lecture, we will be talking about the De Morgan's theorem and the properties of modulus and the amplitude of a complex number. And we will move on with our lecture. So meet you in the next lecture.